Well, back in 1993, it was the Robin Williams film that got the whole world laughing. Mrs Doubtfire and Lisa Jakub shot to the dizzying heights of child superstardom when she played Lydia. Check it out.
Hello, Lydia.
This isn't fair, Mom. Why do we need a housekeeper anyway?
Oh, this is all I need right now.
Look, why can't Dad do it?
Excuse me, dear, but I don't think it's appropriate to argue with your mother in front of a perfect stranger, if you don't mind my saying so.
I just don't see why we can't spend the extra time with Dad.
I'm not who you think I am.
Yeah, no.
Watch your mouth, young man.
Oh, my God. Dad?
Yeah.
Dad?
Yeah, honey. Oh, sorry, it's good.
Oh, what a movie. Now this child star has all grown up. She's quit Hollywood and is a mental health advocate, among many other things.
Yeah, Lisa Jakub joins us from her home in New York now. Lisa, it's great to see you. You look exactly the same, I must say. Yeah.
Oh, my gosh. Thank you. Tristan and Sarah, I'm so glad to be here with you. Thank you for having me.
Oh,
thank
we're you. Excited to talk to you. Now, Lisa, you shot to fame. You're only 14 years old when you hit those dizzying heights of child superstardom. What was that like for you? Was it a whirlwind?
It was a little bit. By the time we filmed Mrs. Doubtfire, I had been working as an actor for 10 years already, so I started very young. But when I took the job, I just kind of thought it was any other job. I knew it was a good script. I knew Robin was going to be hilarious. I was definitely very concerned about whether or not the plot would be believable at all. So, yeah, I think we were all a little bit worried about that for a while.
What about all those things that feed into child stardom? Were you surrounded by, things that kids really shouldn't be surrounded by at that age?
Sure. Yeah, film sets are very adult places. It can be really challenging to be a kid on a film set. Doubtfire was one of those places that did it really well. We felt like a family. They took really good care of us. But yes, generally speaking, film sets are not always the safest place for kids.
Yeah. You've also said before that Robin Williams was very open and honest about his issues with anxiety, depression, and substance abuse. What did he talk to you about being 14?
Well, I was so grateful that Robin was so open with me about his experiences with mental wellness issues. I had already been struggling with anxiety, depression, a panic disorder, and he really taught me that it was nothing to be ashamed of, that I was not alone. And he really kind of modeled for me this idea that in being vulnerable, in being honest about what you're going through, you can really empower other people to own their stories, to get help, to get the support that they need. And that was incredibly impactful for me and really has carried with me through my life and has an impact on everything that I do today.
That's so beautiful to hear that he was such a decent man to you. You played your on-screen dad, of course. He must have felt like a father in some ways, a father figure in a way.
Yes, absolutely. We really felt like a family, and everybody took such good care of us. And that doesn't always happen on set. So it was a very special environment. And I think a lot of that came through on screen, and audiences could feel that.
He always comes across like such a fun guy, like the type of person that you would listen to. I'm not saying that other people wouldn't be, but certainly a character like that would be such a strong influence at the time. How true is it that Robin, he improvised so much that they're actually PG-13, R-rated cuts of the film?
So we would always do a few takes that were fairly close to the script. And then Robin would call for the blue version, the dirty version. So then we would do the dirty takes. And so I know there is a lot of very spicy footage out there. Chris Columbus was talking about this. And it's not like there are fully edited versions of the film, but there is a lot of footage with a lot of really good, really dirty stuff.
Which I'm sure you probably like appreciate a little bit more now. Lisa, what was... I mean, you were kind of riding high at 14, working with the likes of Robin Williams and Sally Field. What was the catalyst for you then to quit Hollywood and become a mental wellness advocate?
So I had no idea what I was going to do when I decided to retire from acting, but I knew that that was something that I needed to move away from for my own mental wellness. I had done it for 18 years by the time I retired, and my anxiety, depression was just through the roof. And I knew that I wanted to do something different with my life, but I had no idea what that was going to be. So it took me quite a while, probably 10 years, to figure out kind of what would be a more authentic path for me. And I've found that as an author. I've written 2 books. I'm working on my third. And I love being able to talk about these really important topics of mental health and different tools that we can use to just feel a little bit better, because the world is really hard. Mm-hmm. So it took me a while to get there, but I'm very grateful for my path.
Oh, it's definitely a great thing that you're doing. We kind of, you realize now much more how important the listener is as well as the speaker when it comes to mental health. As a mental wellness speaker though, what would your best advice be for someone who might be struggling with their mental health?
I think the first thing to know is that you are not alone. I felt like such a weirdo for such a long time, thinking that everybody else was fine and I was the only one who was struggling. So first of all, you're not alone. Next, I think it's really important to understand that reaching out and asking for help is an act of courage. There can be so much stigma around that I really think we need to get rid of. And I think it really is all about remembering that there are options. Even when you feel hopeless, when you feel like you've tried everything, when you feel exhausted and like you just can't go on one more step, there are options for you. And so I think it's incredibly important to really be talking about these things in a really honest way.
Yeah, it really is. And we're delighted we got the chance to speak to you about it. Lisa, it's been a great pleasure to catch up with you, and you're doing really great things.
Just as lovely in real life. You are lovely. Thank you for joining us.
Oh, I appreciate it. Thank you.
Take care. Stay safe. Stay happy.